Let's say that hypothetically, you're an OSU player, and you happen to have a completely terrible sleeping schedule. If you can relate, this video might just be for you. Hello everyone, hope you're doing well. I need a haircut, yes, I know, but that will come with time. Stealth builds, silent mechanical keyboards have been around for quite some time. Personally, I never really understood the appeal. Sure, it's nice to build a silent keyboard if you just want to challenge yourself, but unless you type like this... it generally doesn't make that big of a difference in my opinion. With OSU, however, even when you try to keep it quiet, things are gonna more or less sound like this.
Hey, can you shut the fuck up?
Yeah. If you have parents, neighbors, roommates, self-respect, you probably wouldn't play OSU when it's very late at night. But what if I told you there was a way to do it? I originally wanted to build a super silent mechanical keyboard with OSU in mind, but I figured why go through all of that when I could instead make the most silent OSU keypad with exclusively gameplay in mind. I got my SimPad right here, so it's time to get to work. Let's get into it. I've got my keypad in a nice and shiny red color today, since I'm using the Timeless Classic RGB Cherry MX red switches. Since I'm going for a silent build, I will unplug the keypad and swap those out for some Cherry MX silent red switches. These are a lot quieter in sound, and I don't know if you can tell, but the red color on the stem is definitely less intense. Here's how they sound like. Pretty good, but we can do better. Time to whip out the good old Crytox 205 Grade Zero double O brush and switch opener. You guessed it, it's lubing time. As you can probably tell, I got all this equipment on keycrocs.co.uk, where you can use code SPAZA at checkout for 5% off your first order. I'm gonna push the switch in to separate all parts, and right here on the stem you can actually see exactly how silent switches work. There's some rubber padding on the stem, which essentially limits the impact of the switch when bottoming out, significantly reducing its output volume. Personally, I'm not a huge fan of silent switches, since they feel completely different compared to standard ones, and I find them to be a bit mushy. Even then, since I'm going for stealth and not sound, I'm gonna make some sacrifices. After lubing the bottom housing along with the golden leaf, I'm gonna lube the spring manually, since it's only two of them and there's really no point in bag lubing. Before I lube the stem, I've got a surprise. Desk keys, switch films. Yep, I'm gonna be using some of those bad boys in an upcoming build, so I figured I'd experiment around first. Switch films are small pieces of rubber that go in between the top and bottom housing of the switch, and they're mainly used to reduce wobble, though they also provide better sound and feel. I know it seems counterproductive to use them in this situation since, admittedly, there's not much sound to begin with, but again, I really just wanted an excuse to try them out. Get that film in there, stem holder by the cross, and here I could very well overloop, but I'm trying to keep it nice and balanced, since I still want it to be functional for OSU. Reassembling the switch, it snaps right in place, and oh my god, that is quiet, it's almost unhearable. Do it one more time and switches are ready to go. For the keypad itself, I went ahead to disassemble it. It's a pretty tight fit, so there's not much space for foam or anything similar, unfortunately. I thought about putting a band-aid in there or tape modding, but that would have likely achieved the completely opposite effect, creating a more poppy, marbly, and louder sound, so I abandoned the idea. As I was thinking on what to do next, I noticed two crucial details. As you can see, there's a small hole in the bottom, and the gap created by the sticky pads is actually where most of the noise comes from. Since there's some empty space between the bottom part and the desk once it's stuck on there, if I were to put some foam under the keypad instead of inside, I could have made it even quieter. And so, the hunt for foam began. Everything I had was way too thick to fit under there, but sometimes the solution is right in front of you. Turns out my old dirty ass mouse mat is actually just the correct thickness, and I intended to change it soon anyway. So you know what? Let's take some equally as dirty half-broken scissors and cut this thing up to size. I didn't glue it or anything, since any extra layers could impact the original thickness. I simply placed it between the sticky pads, and as it turns out, it works just fine. Even though things like switches, material and surface matter way more for sound, keycaps still play a role, and there's a ton of different options out there. The keycaps that come with SimPad are OEM profile, and they are row 4, meaning they are essentially as tall as an escape key. Generally speaking, taller keycap profiles like SA tend to give a deeper sound signature, or FOC if you will. And while Cherry Profile is definitely the most popular among keyboard enthusiasts, depending on the board they may actually amplify certain ticks or other high-pitched noises. In order to avoid that, I've decided to go for something in between the two. OEM Profile Row 1 keycaps. Not too tall, but not too short either. Before I put everything back together, it's time to bring out the forbidden keyboard tool, O-rings. O-rings are small rubber rings that you can put on the stems of your keycaps to dampen the sound of the keycap hitting the top of the switch housing. They work very well, they do mute the sound, but they are very much hated in the keyboard community since they can make your keyboard sound and feel a bit mushy, almost like a membrane keyboard. After applying the O-ringed keycaps, I found the angle to be kind of awkward, so even though it might not be aesthetically pleasing, I opted to put them on backwards. Now it's time to find out just how quiet they really are. Hello, post-production Spaza here. I really wanted the audio test to be as unedited as possible, but since, spoiler alert, the keypad is extremely quiet, I had to normalize the audio, and as a result there was a lot of background noise created. I really wanna stress this, there's no compressor, no equalizers of any kind. The only filter I applied is background noise removal. Listen to this. I think the keypad is undeniably very, very quiet. And you do have to take into account that my mic is literally right there at maximum gain, so in person it sounds way quieter than it does on this test. When it comes to OSU, I was actually very surprised with the results. I thought the combination of looped silent switches plus O-rings would make the keypad quiet, but damn near unplayable. But as it turns out, it's perfectly functional. I had no issues with my gameplay, and switches didn't feel as mushy or as sluggish as I had originally anticipated. It's worth mentioning, I'm used to heavier switches, so it's not like I'm 100% comfortable playing like this. But the experience almost makes me think that this type of mod could actually be viable to play very late at night. There are silent black switches out there, so if I don't fix my own sleeping schedule ASAP, I might have to actually think about it. With my mic on the side and me tapping with my normal strength, here's how the keypad sounds like. Needless to say, I'm gonna call this a big success. If you'd like to get this keypad for yourself, you can do so on momokai.com, and use code Spaza at checkout for 10% off. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, road to 50k, and leave your thoughts in the comment section down below. That being said, please don't play OSU at 3 AM, actually go to sleep, and I'll see you all in my next video. Have a good one, guys.